Breaking right now at 11, Northport police swarmed Brian Laundrie's home after reports of gunshots. Northport police say no one on scene heard the shots and they didn't find any shell casings in the area. Police don't know who called that report in. Thanks for counting on NBC2. I'm Brenna White.
And I'm Peter Bush. It's been 10 days since Brian disappeared. Tonight, his family lawyer is confirming to NBC2 Brian left without his phone and wallet. And his parents say they were concerned Brian would harm himself, but they still waited 3 days to report him missing.
We also just uncovered new information about the indictments against Brian. Prosecutors requested an arrest warrant because they believe Brian is a serious flight risk and could try to obstruct justice. Officials also say Brian is a safety concern for others and the community. Remember, Brian was indicted for using someone else's debit cards to withdraw more than $1,000. Tonight, we've learned that crime could land him up to 10 years in prison.
Meanwhile, people who never met Gabby Petito are lining up in our community to pay tribute. NBC2's Megan Myers is at the growing memorial in Northport.
As Gabby Petito's family prepares for her funeral in New York on Sunday, her memorial here in Northport is shining bright.
We made like over 100.
It started with knots, tied with two loops and two loose ends.
Missing children, the green.
It's her favorite color also.
And as time went on, it turned to something bigger.
My grandma like blew down a bunch of the pictures and like made sure that everyone had an idea of like who she was.
Then came the phone calls to the city.
The city actually came out and placed signs as far as this being Gabby's memorial area.
So that friends, family, strangers.
Like, after she like seen her in like the store and stuff.
Neighbors.
She lived really close.
And anyone who feels a connection to Gabby Petito can come here.
Keeping her in our thoughts and our hearts.
Behind each cross, each photo.
She's just like a ray of sunshine, you know, throughout her photos. And you have your heart just, you know, reaches out to her.
Every handwritten letter and all of the ribbons. There's a reason.
Kind of like a one big family helping their kid out.
Showing how Gabby Petito left a mark on someone's life.
Tomorrow night we're going to be letting off 100 live butterflies.
Bringing some peace, comfort, and hope.
She was obsessed with butterflies.
During this tragedy in Northport, Megan Myers, NBC2.
Today police spent their sixth day combing through the Carlton Reserve, but still no sign of Brian Laundrie. Experts say if he's actually in there, they doubt he could survive this long in those brutal elements. You can see the swampy, muddy trails. They're not easy to pass. Josh Greer's family moved to South Florida more than 100 years ago. He camps and hunts in the wilderness, but he wouldn't spend more than a couple days out there.
They're doing every day for 3 or 4 days. You're done. You need a week off. I don't think he's here. If he was here, they'd have found him. And if he is here, he's probably not alive.
Northport police say they'll be back out at the preserve tomorrow to search for a seventh day. Count on NBC2 to alert you first if investigators find anything in their search. When we're not on air, we are keeping you updated on the NBC2 News app.